Hey everyone, I'm Mac Murdoch here with OPT, and today we're going to be going over the QHYCCD Polemaster. The Polemaster is a perfect tool to help you achieve perfect polar alignment in under 5 minutes. In this video, we're going to run through how to set it up so that you can get it right on your first try. The Polemaster is able to fit a variety of different mounts as long as you have the right adapter for it. For this video, I'll be using the Skywatcher EQ6R Pro. To start, you want to fit the adapter into the polar scope opening and use your hex key to tighten the set screws inside to lock it in place. Next, you want to screw the other side of the adapter onto the Polemaster camera. Finally, you place the Polemaster onto your mount and tighten the set screw. The Polemaster comes with a USB connection so you can plug it into your computer. Before you can start using the Polemaster, you have to download the driver and the software onto your computer. Be sure to do that where you have an internet connection before you go out and shoot.
All right, so here we are inside of the Polemaster software. The first thing we're gonna do is go to the top where it says device and click connect. And this will actually connect your computer with the Polemaster. If you're roughly polar aligned, you should see Polaris on your screen and hopefully you don't have any trees in your view like I do. Up here, it asks which hemisphere you're in. We're shooting in Los Angeles, so we're gonna leave it at north. Over here, you can adjust the Polemaster settings and make it easier to see the stars. You don't want to make it too bright because if you do, your stars will be all bloated and you actually get a finer adjustment if you leave it at a low setting. I think for this, we'll leave it at exposure 100 and gain 70. And now we're going to try and get our pointer as close to the center of Polaris as we can. And then we'll double click it. These circles will pop up. The slider over here moves the circles around. But you can also hit the plus or minus keys on the screen or the plus or minus keys on your keyboard. They both work the same. Or you can click the slider and drag it to move the circles faster. We want to line these circles up with their respective stars. So I'm going to fine-tune it with the buttons. Okay, so we see the stars are in the circles. Once that's done, we can hit success. It's telling us to choose a star other than Polaris. So we're gonna choose this star and get as close to the center as possible, and then we're gonna double click. It's gonna ask us to rotate the mount clockwise 30 degrees. So we're gonna do that right now. About there is good. Once that's done, we'll click finish. We're gonna double click the same star one more time and rotate it 30 degrees again. And by the way, you can either rotate the mount by hand or you can use whatever software you want to move the mount electronically. It doesn't matter. So we'll double click that star one more time and now a green circle will appear on the screen. So we're gonna move our mount back to the home position and we wanna make sure that our star follows that green circle. So we're gonna click Polaris again and those circles are gonna pop right back up. We're gonna do the same thing as before, move the circles on top of the stars and then click success. Now we're gonna adjust the altitude and azimuth knobs and we want Polaris to be in this circle. So we're trying to get as close as possible. I'm pretty happy with this. So let's hit finish. Now we're gonna double click Polaris one last time. And after we click it, we're gonna make sure these circles are still around their stars. The final step is to click start monitor right over here. And we're gonna see a green square and a red circle. The whole point of this is to get the green square on the red circle. What helps is leaving your mouse on top of the red circle so that it stays enlarged on the top left corner. This just makes it easier to be precise with your alignment. And just so you know, it's completely normal that your green square jumps around a little bit. That's because of bad seeing and atmospheric distortion that's out of your control. So don't stress and just get it as close as you can. And once you get those two aligned, you can click done and be fully polar aligned with the North Celestial Pole and be ready to image whatever you want in the night sky. Once you start polar aligning with the Polemaster, there's no going back. If you're interested in getting a Polemaster for yourself, we've included the link in the description below for you to check out. If you guys found this video helpful, be sure to leave us a like and give us your thoughts in the comment section below. Remember to subscribe if you haven't already, and we'll be seeing you in the next video. Clear skies.